Now you know you got to go.
Hey, hey.
Oh,
ho.
Now you know. like to welcome you and thank you for coming out. Secondly, I'd like to tell you that this is the time to raise your voices and be heard. And sadly, I need to tell you that one of the most strongest and stark fighters of Baby Hunters Point history has passed this past week. Espinola Jackson, our son, Dr. Espinola Jackson, she's gone to heaven, but please trust me. If there's a fight going on, she is right here with us. And in her honor, we need to let Lennar know and the EPA know that this stuff has got to stop happening to poor folks. We will not be chased out of Baby Hunters Point, and we will not be chased out of San Francisco. We will not be gentrified out of San Francisco. And we will not be gentrified out of San Francisco, period. Or Treasure Island by any means. We're here today, and we're here to make a statement that the fight is just starting all over again. We just took a break. We're back in it to win it. That means that no matter how long it takes, we will continue on until we win our battle. We need our shipyard clean. We need decent housing built, but we need housing for people who are already living in slum conditions, who are already there, who live, raise their children, die, trade, and work in Baby Hunters Point and on Treasure Island and any place that this foul company has been. We need to let them know that we have solidarity from all across the country, from every place they've been. People are saying, shut them down. We need to shut Lennar down. We need to shut this city down. So in the name of Espinola Jackson, I'd like to say keep the fight going. Don't give up. We don't surrender. We take no prisoners. Are we understanding? Does everybody understand? We take no prisoners. That means we're not going to believe in all the bull that they're talking about, how clean things are. We're not going to believe in all the garbage that they're shoveling about us not being gentrified or eased out of our communities. Mass evictions means you're gone. You ain't coming back. There's no way for you to come back. We need to put a stop to that, and we need to put a stop to that now. So we have a list of demands, and Bradley's going to read those demands to you because, unfortunately, I have another case I have to handle. And trust me, I will be doing that, or y'all will be hearing the noise and understand the screaming. It will just be me, just getting started.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, we don't need Lennar no more. 1, 2, 3, 4, we don't need Lennar no more. 1, 2, 3, 4,
no more. 1, 2, 3. Toxic and radioactive waste? I mean, it's real. A few months ago, we went into, when we realized this office was here, which at the time on the side, you see these nice pictures? On the side, they had a picture of white people drinking red wine. Not quite the Bayview Hunters Point that we know and you know. And we want to make sure that residents of Bayview Hunters Point benefit from their long struggle for a healthy and clean community and not get forced out or contaminated by Lennar. So, but we do have victory number one to report today in our new struggle with all of you that's brought together people from Bayview Hunters Point, Treasure Island, and Yerba Buena, the Mission. Notice, Lennar is closed today. They ran, but they cannot hide. So our message to Lennar is we shut you down today, and now we need you to get the hell out of our town.
That's right.
So in a couple of minutes, I'm just going to read the demands that we have both for Lennar and for the U.S. Environmental, quote-unquote, Environmental Protection Agency, which coincidentally is right around the corner and will be going there at 12:45. So to Lennar, number one, Lennar's website, shipyardsfshipyard.com, which promotes home sales at the shipyard, must tell the truth. They must clearly inform potential buyers about the Superfund site that has radioactive and toxic waste. And we say, stop hiding the truth.
Stop hiding the truth.
Number two, we want Lennar to abandon plans for the mega development for rich people at 16th in the Mission.
Woo! Yeah.
So no monster in the mission. It's another community under attack. Number three, we want a moratorium on building on or next to contaminated sites until and unless environmental health and climate issues are fully addressed, and until and unless all the toxic and radioactive waste are cleaned up with no exposure to new and existing residents. And if they do build in our communities, they need to build real affordable housing, not make-believe affordable housing, and stop displacing our low-income and people of color residents. When we go around to US EPA, we're going to demand scientific proof of their claims that all this is safe. We want new studies, including cumulative impacts on all the pollution, and as sea level is rising due to climate change, all the toxic waste of the shipyard may end up in the front yards of some of these fancy new homes. But we don't want anybody poisoned, existing or future residents, and they have not studied the most up-to-date information. So with that, let me turn this over to Leotis Martin, who's a longtime Bayview Hunters Point resident, and he'll let us know what he thinks about all this. And then I want to invite folks from the other communities affected by Lennar to step up and share your thoughts. So please welcome Leotis Martin.
Yes, I'm Leotis Martin. And the first thing I would like to say is that this is not a game. This is not a game. This is not a game. When people's lives are at stake, this is not a game. When all you're thinking about is just money and not thinking about the welfare of the other people, period, this is not a game. Lennar, you must go. You know, in the shipyard, they have trucks coming out, and these trucks ain't even covered up. And this site only been capped. It haven't been cleaned up. It been capped up. You know, what's going to happen when the earthquake comes? What's going to happen when the rise of sea level comes 20, 30 years from now? You know? Then what's going to happen to the kids and their fathers and their mothers that's living on this land that's contaminated? What's going to happen when somebody lose their parent and their kid is only 2 years old? That's a loss that they have to suffer with for the rest of their life. This is not a game. This is not a game. This is not a game. You know, this is about lives. The EPA ain't even stepping in and doing the right thing. Our welfare as people come first and foremost before dollars. Period. Period. But they allowed Lennar to do this stuff over and over and over again. So they sold out to Lennar. Lennar owns the EPA. The EPA don't own Lennar because they sold out to them. This is not a game. We're sick and tired of this. We've been pushed out of our own communities by Lennar and these condominiums and these townhouses that I can't even afford. And I've been working daily all my life and can't afford to move in one of these places. So where I got to go, to Oakland? No, I ain't going nowhere. I'm staying put. This is not a game. My community is changing. It's changing to the rich people. The poor people don't have nowhere to go. You know? We don't have nowhere to go, and that's not right. Don't push us out. We've been here all our lives, 30, 40 years, when the place was a slum, before they even start thinking about building on top of this $8 million, $10 million land. Yeah, we was here. And the shipyard, you know, it's not fully clean, period. You know, it's not fully clean, and they allow, and the EPA allowing all this stuff to go down. And that's not right. The EPA need to stand up and do their job. Do it right. Do it correctly. That's why we out here, to let y'all know that this is not a game. This is not a game. What about the little children that's being born today that lives in Bayview, Hunters Point, that got to go to the hospital once a month, maybe twice a month, maybe three times a month, that have asthma, cancer, you know? Because of all these things that's going on and people don't care, but we care. This is not a game. Now, if it was your kid, would you want too kid to be contaminated, all because people are not doing their job right, and all they're thinking about is the dollars and cents. It makes dollars, but it ain't making no damn sense. It makes dollars, but it ain't making no damn sense. It makes dollars, but it ain't making no damn sense when it comes to the well-being of the people. There we go.
Please welcome Andy from the Plaza 16 Coalition in the Mission.
Hey, everybody.
Here we go.
Hey, everybody. This is amazing. Let's give yourselves a hand for coming out here today. We shut down Lennar. They didn't even show up because they knew the community was going to be here and was going to disgrace them. I'm from the Plaza 16 Coalition. We are here in solidarity. The mission to the Bayview, to Treasure Island. Lennar is toxic for our communities and toxic for our city. Lennar wants to build what we have deemed the Titanic mess on South Van Ness. And you knew what happened when the Titanic was sinking. Who suffered? Who died? The workers, the working class, the people of color. That's who suffered when the Titanic sank. And we need no more luxury condos in the mission. The mission has made that clear. We fought the monster in the mission, we fought the beast on Bryant, and now we're fighting Lennar's Titanic mess on South Van Ness. So we're here in solidarity. Again, Lennar is toxic for black and brown communities. Lennar is toxic for San Francisco. Let's stop Lennar. Thank you, everybody. No Titanic mess on South Van Ness. No Titanic mess on South Van Ness. No Titanic mess. On South Van Ness. Thank you, everybody.
Let me bring up Carol Harvey and then Becky from Gilbert Buena. Eddie, I'm sorry. But here is Carol Harvey.
Okay, how many of you have a way of mentally envisioning $10 billion? Raise your hand if you can mentally envision that. Okay, you can. How many of you have a way of mentally envisioning 1,400 cubic pounds of dirt? I'm sorry, it's 14,000 cubic pounds of dirt. You can envision that. I can't, but if you look at Treasure Island or go to Treasure Island, you'll see a quote-unquote hill in the middle of Treasure Island. That is one-fifth of 1,400 cubic pounds of dirt. And they're going to spread that. Lennar is going to spread that all over Treasure Island. And they're going to pound it down with big pounders to make sure that it's safe from liquefaction and ocean rise. And all the while, people who've been living there in housing next to remediation sites where they're supposedly pulling out chemicals and radiation will be subjected to this pounding. That's what Lennar and the city and the Navy and John Stewart are doing to the residents of Treasure Island. And I know 50 people who have asthma and various kinds of cancers, at least 50. There are no longitudinal studies of people becoming ill on Treasure Island. I know a lot of them personally. They are suffering. Dust. Remember Hunter's Point and the problem with dust? Well, the same thing is happening on Treasure Island. They're saying trucks that are doing this remediation driving by are covered. They are not. The biggest disease on Treasure Island is asthma. Remember that on Hunter's Point?
Yes.
Okay, but what's happening on Treasure Island is an atrocity at the hands of Lennar. And Treasure Island has not been covered by the media because they don't want people to know what's happening there. and they need support from the community. So I'm really glad that this is happening today. They kicked out the people on Yerba Buena, and they're going to find ways to do that to the people on Treasure Island, just like they did in Hunter's Point. I've written an article about some of this at the San Francisco Bayview newspaper, going back through all the history of what they did at Hunter's Point and preparing people for the fact that they're going to do it on Treasure Island. So we need to focus on what's happening at Treasure Island. And if you can't envision 1,400 cubic pounds of dirt, then don't feel like the Lone Ranger. But it's going to be there. I don't know what's going to happen to Job Corps. Is Job Corps going to be down in a hole? This is very curious. Okay, let's support the people at Treasure Island who are being poisoned. Oh, and by the way, radiation? Radiation! I asked the Navy, what are they going to do about the fact that when they dumped all this dirt on top of Treasure Island to hide the evidence, radiation doesn't go away. Radiation is called radiation because it radiates. You can't get rid of it. And if you look at Treasure Island, the way Lennar has painted pictures of it, two-thirds of it is a park, just like Chrissy Field. Did you know Chrissy Field is toxic? Don't ever take your family there. Don't let little kids crawl around on it. That's what they want to happen at Treasure Island. So, thanks a lot.
Okay, hi all, I'm one of the co-organizers my name's Eric Brooks, I'm with Our City San Francisco and the San Francisco Green Party, and also 350SF. We just heard about what's happening on Treasure Island. Now we're going to hear about how not only toxic development but gentrification are combined together by Yerba Buena Island people being kicked off of their island to shift them to the radioactive island. So Betty Mackey from Yerba Buena Island residents, please let us know what's going on.
Thank you, because you're in a minority in the city of San Francisco. Every time you ask the mayor a question about the illegal transfer of Yerba Buena Island to Lennar and to Kenwood and Associates, or to all of these organizations for development there, they shift the conversation to talk about how much affordable housing that they're going to build on Treasure Island. They never tell you a due date for cleanup. They never tell you anything about real numbers on fixing the problems associated with the landfill there. And they also never tell you how Lennar and all of its associates are going to make hundreds of millions of dollars on 285 luxury condos. They don't tell you how the affordable housing component on Yerba Buena Island is 15 units. They don't tell you how they are planning to make that expirable after 20 or 25 years. They are not permanent homes. It's going to repeat the same problem that is happening at the Marina South Beach apartments, where those people are terrified after living there 20 years that their leases are up. And the District 6 supervisor is not doing anything to help folks on Treasure Island, South Beach Marina Apartments, or any of the people who were evicted from Yerba Buena Island. Her advice to all of the residents that ask for help is to get a lawyer. While she goes on her Senate campaign to say that she's doing so much to build tenant protections for everyone else in the city, we are the redheaded stepchildren that she beats in the closet every night. The problem with all of this is that, unbeknownst to everyone, on top of all the crappy stuff that they're doing within city government, by giving this land away...
You need to hit that button. You just turn it off.
Turn it up?
No, just hit the button.
I am
the sound just went away.
We can hear her.
The problem on top of this is Lennar, in all of its corporate greed, is creating an IPO for an organization called Five Points Communities, or Five Points Holdings, in that they speculate on how well the homes in Bayview Hunters Point, on Treasure Island, and on Yerba Buena Island, on New Hall Ranch, and the former El Toro base in Southern California. Once that IPO
IPOs, all of the people that have that basic founder stock are going to become billionaires or very darn close to it. What I would like to know is how much stock does Willie Brown own in Five Point Holdings? I'd like to know how much stock Ed Lee has in Five Point Holdings.
Nancy Pelosi.
How much stock does Nancy Pelosi and Barbara Boxer and Dianne Feinstein have in Five Point Holdings? These are all private. These are all private and protected and will only come to light when they cash that stock in. Nobody's answering these questions. I took these questions to city government and met with Steve Cava, who said that he would look into it, and lied. I never heard back from him except to say, you're evicted from Yerba Buena Island. All of these things need to be fought and investigated, and I'm in solidarity with everyone at Bayview Hunters Point because they are using it all, using us all, and when they get away with one step, it just encourages them to continue and to abuse everyone, and they don't care who's sick or who dies as a result of their greed. Solidarity. Thank you.
All right, Betty, thank you. Once again, I'm Eric Brooks. I'm with the San Francisco Green Party with Our City San Francisco that has helped work a lot on the Lennar issues over the past decade. And I just want to give a tiny bit more history on Lennar Corporation. Lennar Corporation is a Wall Street corporation that was involved in construction and trading, one of the biggest construction companies involved in the subprime mortgage scandal. They produced more properties during that time for those subprime mortgages than any other company. Lennar has built homes in Florida that were knocked down by hurricanes. Lennar has repeatedly made promises in various cities to build affordable housing and rental housing and then defied those promises. Lennar was going to supposedly build affordable housing in Oakland and failed out when it knew that it was going to be actually required to build affordable housing. So that's just some examples of Lennar. Lennar got over $1 billion in a bailout when it was in danger of bankruptcy from the federal government. So this is a corporation that embodies what's wrong with the international global finance system. And then just to bring it down, kind of to put on my 350 SF hat, the big thing here is that toxic waste and sea level rise and earthquake liquefaction, which means the soil turns to something like water when an earthquake hits, are all involved in this process. That's why 350 is involved in this process, because all over the world right now, the communities that are going to get hit the hardest by sea level rise and climate change are communities of color and low-income communities and colonized countries and colonized neighborhoods like the Bayview Hunters Point and Treasure Island. One thing I want to add to what Betty Mackey said, with the Yerba Buena Island residents who are kind of up on a higher rock that's not going to be flooded, we're given a choice. You can take $5,000 to move, or you can move to an island that has radiation on it, Treasure Island. So guess what most people picked? They moved to the island, right? So Treasure Island and Bayview Hunters Point have radiation and toxic waste out the wazoo. You've already heard about that. What happens when you get over a meter of sea level rise and get up to a meter of sea level rise is that the seawater comes up and interacts with all the chemicals that are under the ground and spreads them all over the place. The Treasure Island and the Bayview were all built on bay soils that were dredged up, not natural, very loose. Liquefaction happens immediately when there's an earthquake in a region like that. And the Treasure Island will not be safe during an earthquake. More than two-thirds of the island isn't even going to be compacted at all. There's a question about whether the compaction will work. And so when you've got an earthquake coming in with liquefaction and you've got sea level rise, we're talking about a combination of Katrina and Sandy and Tuvalu. I mean, this is a toxic disaster waiting to happen, exacerbated badly by climate change, and it's going to be hitting the poorest people and the most marginalized people in our community. And so this stuff makes Lennar Corporation the biggest
bad, nastiest, evilest real estate corporation in this city. And now that they're spreading out and expanding to the Mission and eventually other neighborhoods, we need to shut them the hell down.
Yeah. All right, I'm taking Leo in. In about 6 or 7 minutes, we're going to go around the corner to the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, PD9 headquarters, and ask them, since their name, I believe, is Environmental Protection Agency, and they claim they support environmental justice, and they are required to comply with civil rights, why the hell they're saying that it's okay for babies to crawl on top of the park they plan to let Lennar build on top of toxic and radioactive waste. And one of the lower staff members of EPA was going to come out and talk to us for a few minutes, and we just got word that the regional administrator, the main guy, Jared Blumenfeld, will actually be coming out. So, which is really good. So, and we know that EPA has been freaking out about this for several weeks now. So we've not only shut Lennar down here today, but we do have the attention of the top officials at EPA. So give a hoot and holler for all of us. And when we go around the corner to EPA in a couple of minutes, Jared may have a statement, but we're going to read our demands and ask for follow-up meetings with them. And they are actually committed to meeting with all of us. But, you know, their basic message is it's a done deal at the shipyard. And our position is, and I think all of us here, you know, justice, it ain't done till justice is won, right? All right, so in the few minutes we got, I wanted to ask if any other community folks affected would like to come up and say a few words.
Step up.
All right. Somebody step up. Let's say somebody you haven't heard of. Mavis Williams from Huntersville.
I'm Mavis Williams from Huntersville, and I just want to say that it is bad up there. I got asthma last year. I got up to 53 years old without having asthma. I turned 54. All of a sudden, I have to use a pump every day. So we need to shut them down, or they need to clean it up. Am I right?
Yes.
So what do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Justice.
What do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
Are we gonna go?
We're gonna do Lennar Air is under attack. We need to stand up, fight back. Lennar health is under attack. What do we do?
Stand up.
Lennar community is under attack. What do we do?
Stand up.
Lennar lungs are under attack. What do we do?
Fight back.
Lennar children are under attack. What do we do?
Stand up. Fight back.
Stand up, 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 fight back.
This is not a game. This is not a game. This is not a game. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. This is not a game. This is not a game. Lennar, you got to go. Lennar, you got to go. Lennar, you have to go. This is not a game.
I want to piggyback on that. This is a massive human rights abuse. This is a massive human rights abuse that's being caused in these four places. That is a civil rights abuse. Because people who are targeted are black, white, and brown, and poor people. This is a human rights abuse, so it is not a game. Thank you.
All right, if
we want to inform, we are here today to inform residents of San Francisco right from the dispatches of southeastern San Francisco, the heart and soul of Bayview Hunters Point neighborhood. letting it be known and informing folks that there's a lot going on that we all need to know about. And we know that San Francisco is going through the largest redevelopment ever in our history. Let me repeat that again, the largest redevelopment ever. From AT&T Park down to our neighborhood. Who's the winner? Who's the loser?
We are.
And who writes the history?
They do.
That's right. So it's time to reclaim that and restore. You know what I want to say is so many times they want to say that our neighborhood is getting gentrified. The new gentry is coming to town. You know, that's the origin of that word, right? The new gentry. Okay? But that's just a little reminder that we're all sharing this little 7x7. Okay? And when this new gentry hopefully comes to town and sees the enmity that is already there between the neighborhood that exists and the neighborhood that companies like Lennar are hoping to attract, okay? We're going to stand our ground. And it's also saying that we are resilient. We are here. We won't go. And we're not only going to stay here, but we're also going to create the future we all deserve. Okay? And that does not include toxic waste. Do we want that in our neighborhood?
No!
Okay. Do we want a division of our neighbors? Of the haves and have-nots reinforced by this city? No.
No!
People want to say kids and toxic waste don't mix, but a lot of the folks who are being attracted to these developments, dual income, no kids. I'm here with my own, beating the odds, raising my own children in this city.
That's right, yeah.
I'm a fleeting demographic, and I hope not to be, okay? So we need to put these developments plans and developers in check and inform all of our fellow residents, the greater Bay Area community, the state, the nation, the globe, to let it know that our environmental justice community will be heard, we will find balance, and we will not go. So I say our communities of color do matter, and we are going to create the future that is balanced with health and justice in our neighborhoods right now. Is that right?
Yeah.
When's that going to happen? Right now?
Yeah.
Okay, it's been happening from time, so remember that. And we can be inspired by the past and bring it forward. To all my relations, we honor you.
Let me say one more thing. Lennar knows about the rising sea level, but they don't give a damn. Lennar knows about the rising sea level, but they don't give a damn. Lennar knows about the rising sea level, but they don't give a damn. Because if it don't make money, it don't make sense to them.
Yeah.
All right, as the raindrops fall, but I don't think it's going to get worse. So we are now, first of all, let's again celebrate our victory shutting this happening out of this office today.
So we're gonna
go down Hawthorne and let the EPA volunteer take that.
We'll be on YouTube in a couple of days.
As we go.
A little video.
And again, we're just gonna go to the front of the EPA office. It's gonna take us 30 seconds to get there.
Yeah.
And let's and again, Jared Blumenfeld, administrator, is going to come out, and we'll talk to him for a couple of minutes.
Yeah,
and it's actually good. So I do, even though we disagree with the EPA's position, they've actually been responsive, and here he is. Okay, but Jared's going to lead us in the march. So our message to EPA is protect the people, not polluters. Protect the people, not polluters. Protect the people, not polluters. Protect the people, not polluters.
Protect the people and not polluters. Protect the people and not polluters. Protect the people and not polluters.
yet.
Okay, well, again, thank you everybody for coming.
Oh, well.
And we did what the EPA should have done, which is shut down the Lennar sales office.
Woo!
Because they're not telling the truth. And again, I encourage everybody to go to sfshipyard.com so you can see what they do say. And anybody who can find a warning to potential home buyers that there's toxic and radioactive waste there, you'll win the super lotto. Or I'll give you whatever I got, because you're not going to find it there. The truth is nowhere to be found on the Lennar website, just a bunch of BS. Anyhow, as everybody knows, and again, we want to thank you all for coming out. We had sent a list of questions to the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, who as a federal agency has a lot of responsibility to make sure that site is safe for current and future use. And there's a lot of agencies involved, from EPA, the Navy, State Department of Toxics, and other agencies. City Hall, but they're too busy being in bed with Lennar to really pay attention. And we have a lot of concerns about the adequacy of the studies that say it's safe to live and for kids to crawl around, to live next to toxic and radioactive waste and for kids to crawl around on top of it. So EPA apparently has a written response. And then let me introduce Jared Blumenfeld, who's the regional administrator of US EPA Region 9, and he's very familiar with this, and we thank EPA for coming out and be willing to do this and come talk to folks. We do appreciate it, even if we do completely disagree with your findings. And but let me hand this to Jared, and then you can respond as you see fit, and then we'll kind of read our demands and ask for a follow-up meeting, and then we'll keep up the struggle. So, Jared.
So when I heard there was an angel coming down Hawthorne Street, I had to come out, right, when Bradley shows up, and all of you. So first of all, thank you, right, because this is the middle of the week, you've all got jobs, lives, and we appreciate you standing up, thinking about the environment, caring about the environment, and taking action. So only through taking action do things change. When EPA was itself created in 1970, after the first Earth Day, when people went out into the streets and said, we need a federal agency. So we take your concerns seriously. We want to know what the issues are, how we can deal with them. As you know, the Navy is the lead, but we're there to oversee them and make sure the cleanup is done properly, and that's what we intend to do. So Bradley asked us a set of questions, and rather than read the answers, I have them here. So we have the question that Bradley asked, and then our answer. So we did our best to do that. Bradley's then going to read. Bradley, maybe give these out.
Sure.
Bradley's then going to read a list of demands, and we're happy to meet with you again, wherever that makes sense, either here or in the Bayview. And thank you, and stay dry. Okay. The camera's red. Bradley, demand.
Okay, actually, first,
Anthony Khalil from Literacy for Environmental Justice would like to address the EPA.
Yeah, I just wanted to address the group and really honor the struggle. It has been a long one. And I want to also acknowledge that there needs to be a change of culture here and investment in southeastern San Francisco beyond development. And I want to say that there has been some lead taking at Yosemite Slough, the largest wetland restoration project in San Francisco. There were the point source of pollution found. And finally, for the first time in our neighborhood, the point source of pollution, it's still under closed doors on who those point sources were historically, but they're still affecting our community decades and decades back. So what I'm asking on behalf of my own personal accord and to start off this list of demands is following from that lead of finding... Yeah, that's right. That's right. It's time. Clock's over, okay? Because the new culture of the town, that's the game buzzer right there to say, you know what? Follow the lead of what you did at Yosemite Slough. Find those point sources of pollution and make them pay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It makes them invest into our neighborhood to thrive.
Yes.
So I want to follow that lead and understand that we have a long way to go and that game clock is a new game in town. And we're here, and we will not go.
Woo! Woo!
All right. So, you know, so while we're sitting here laughing, I mean, this is really a life and death issue. And, you know, a lot of us feel that the studies that were done were not adequate. And even since the environmental impact report was done, there's new studies about sea level rise and storm surges. And EPA claims that, and the Navy claims that what they're planning, which is an improvement of what was planning before, but they're saying that's adequate. We want to have more discussions about that. So one of the things, and EPA made a presentation to our Bayview Hunters Point Environmental Justice Task Force last Thursday and claimed that no radioactivity or toxins would be emitted through the existing landfill, which is going to be turned into open space in a park. And I'm not aware, we're challenging EPA to provide documentation of somewhere on this planet where a cap completely and 100% prevented all radioactivity or all toxic waste from ever, escaping. We don't think that's possible. We don't think it's been done. And if you look at even the radioactive waste dumps licensed by the Fed, that doesn't happen. And also, as you know, there was a fire that raged for months at the landfill. So these are ongoing concerns. So our demands are, one, provide irrefutable scientific proof of EPA's claim that no radioactivity or toxins will be emitted through the landfill cap where a park is planned and where babies will be crawling for years to come if this goes ahead, because they're not planning to clean up all the toxic waste or radioactive waste. Number two, agree to work with all relevant agencies to conduct a study that we don't think was ever done, which is a comprehensive cumulative impact analysis. So where is the study, unless we're wrong, and maybe we are, where's the study, and if it's not been done, it needs to be done before anything more happens, that considered, you know, people living out there now. There's still highly, it's a Superfund site. Where's the study that says what they're being exposed of today or where they'll be exposed tomorrow combined with all the other pollution that exists in the neighborhood, a real cumulative impact study? I'm not aware that was ever done comprehensively. That should be done. EPA is well aware of the science of cumulative impacts. And there's new information and analysis that didn't even exist when the EIR was done. So we want to sit and talk with EPA about these scientific issues. Prove us wrong, or let's agree to address the problem. And thirdly, agree to work with all relevant agencies to conduct a new environmental review on the shipyard Superfund site using the most up-to-date estimates of sea level rise. So we're glad a rock wall and slurry is being built, but we really want to sit down and talk about, is that adequate, including with the increasing storm surges that are happening, the water going under the landfill as well. So, and then lastly, if we could follow up on our request, and I assume you'll agree, to set up a technical meeting, ideally with your agency, the Navy, Department of Toxics, at some time in the very near future. So if we could do that. And last but not least, and here's the question maybe you could answer today, a two-part question. One is, have any of you looked at EPA, the sfshipyard.com website, which is Lennar's sales website?
No.
And if you haven't, I would hope you would. And after... No, they are selling condos. And, I mean, I know some of you for a long time. I don't want to put words in your mouth, but I would, and you don't have to answer this, but I would assume you agree that people should know what they might move next to in terms of a Superfund site. And when you look at sfshipyard.com, we would like EPA to write a letter, because unless you see something we can't find on that website, such as your homes will be next to a Superfund site, and your kids will crawl around on top of a radioactive toxic waste landfill. We want EPA to inform Lennar that you think it's important to them to have, tell the truth in full disclosure. So that's another thing we're going to be following up on, because basically we think EPA is acting as a public relations firm for this company. When you stand up and say it's all safe, people walk into that office, buy a home, and not know what they're buying into. So with that, thank you for coming out today. We'll be following up, and we do appreciate EPA coming out, and you know we'll be back and continue the discussion, and I think Lennar knows we'll be back too. And thanks again, everybody. So what do we want? And when do we want it? And what do we want? And when do we want it? Do you want gentrification?
No.
Do you want more contamination?
No.
Do you want more pollution in our community?
No.
Do you want all the Navy's toxic and radioactive waste floating into the bay or down 3rd Street?
No.
So let's get to work. Thanks, everybody.